According to Norman Musinga, several security checkpoints are to be mounted in strategic locations to ensure that the public complies with the new law. He has warned that all those violating curfew time and other COVID guidelines will face the tough arm of the law.
Planting checkpoints, which we have already started, carrying out enforcement, sensitization, the public, call upon the general public within the Zone West to accept and comply with police's instructions. Those who apply to bus, kindly we request you to respect curfew time, to respect COVID-19 guidelines, COVID-19 restrictions of the Minister of Health.
Musinga has also cautioned players in the transport sector against overspeeding and overloading. On terrorism, he says the general public should avoid huge crowds, report to police any suspicious people and objects.
The bus, people move beyond curfew time, which must stop. It must stop with immediate effect. Those who want to jubilate into their bus, more especially at the end of the year, I am cautioning you and warning you, please, you must adhere to the COVID-19 guidelines. Any suspicious person, a wrong person in your area, kindly tell us, communicate to the respective area police, inform them.
Musinga has also cautioned law offenders against being tempted to bribe police officers, especially those at checkpoints. Meanwhile, the Fort Portal Tourism City leadership has defended the alteration of old building structures in the city. To date, several old buildings in Fort Portal have been modified and redesigned. In the alteration process, some of the buildings that were formerly constructed for residential purposes have now been redesigned to accommodate shops and lockups, while some other buildings on the main street have been partitioned.
Complicate the environment. So we, the five, and our brothers and sisters, the technocrats, we are here to make sure that environment is conducive enough for our people to come from Kiaka, to come from Mwenge, to come from Bundibugyo, to come from Kasese, to come from Bakagamba, Tingine Nkaito, Tingineki, Mvaye Kalike, Kitamkila Habibun, Bito Ningenda for Potro, no Wika. This is the situation we are working to bring about.
But buildings in the construction business will need to be, but it must be authorized. Because when you are putting up that building, it was not in position around. There were other surroundings. We want to be sure that your alteration is not going to affect others unduly. So alterations are allowed, but they must be authorized.
According to Kato, an economist, the continuous alteration of buildings in Fort Portal is delaying implementation of the city fiscal plan, whose intention is to guide the development of the city. He also argues that a well-built city would attract bigger investors, and yet the alteration of buildings would in the long run give birth to a slum city.
Modifying the structure that we have in the city, it gives a cheap rent or property. People are working from within to operate the shops and kiosks. But the big worry is by availing rentals to the available population now, and you forget that this place has graduated from being a municipality into a tourism city, that we need a real core of urbanization. And by just heating and modifying the structure that we have to create more kiosks and rooms, it violates now the implementation of the physical planning of this city.
Reverend Ikintu Muhanga, a former mayor for Fort Portal, blames government for not actualizing the newly created cities.
If they cannot, what have we done? What has the current leadership done to attract other investors to come in town so that they can equally develop this town? So it's a question that we are putting across, and it is a concern of everyone. So we pray that the physical planning policy is going to be implemented, whereby at least people within the CBD should construct a three-storied structures so that we can have a beautiful scenery of our town.
Story by Roger Sunday for the news.